Design Salvation, Episode 61.
This is Design Salvation, your lifeline to better design with Dixie and Annie. Our mission is to share our conversation with you so we can all elevate our work and lifestyle. Welcome to the fold.
Hey y'all, it's Dixie Stark.
And Annie Lundquist.
We're Design Salvation.
We are, this is 61?
I believe so.
I think that's just amazing.
I know. It's like a big hurdle. It sounds like a good number, doesn't
it? Sounds like
it?
A good number.
I like it.
We're middle-aged.
Yeah, the podcast is middle-aged now, yes. Just like us.
I think 50 was middle-aged, but we're moving
yeah, we're
it up.
We're really moving on to the next
or maybe
level,
40
right?
Was at some point.
I mean, my goodness, yeah. I can't even believe it. So what did we do today? We tested stuff.
We did,
drink,
yeah,
and we
did.
We were kind of like,
yeah, we taste tested a bunch of non-alcohol. Oh no, two were sangrias in cute little bottles that we thought would be fun.
Oh, the bottles are adorable.
They're adorable bottles, but we nixed them. Not good enough.
My sangria's better.
Your sangria is infinitely better.
Thank you.
And I think anybody can make a better sangria than that. I don't like that. Was called Lolia or something.
Yeah, and I think it's just hard when you bottle anything. So, you know, there
true.
You have it.
True, and then there we didn't like some German grapefruit soda
yeah,
that Lulu picked up.
Something
that was
else.
Nothing.
That
was a waste of time.
That's it. Yeah, ixnay.
And then we liked the rose lemonade and the pretty
bottle.
Yeah, that
was
pretty
nice
bottle.
Surprise.
That
really
was
cute bottle and a really lovely color and quite refreshing. So
yeah.
There you go. And you can mix it with alcohol, but you don't have to.
Yeah. We
yeah.
Did that. And then we love the San Pel.
Always.
Blood orange.
Yeah,
that's
always.
What we landed on.
That's just
on
kind of a good,
it's a good go-to.
It's always a good go-to.
But you
so
could alcohol that up, probably.
Oh, yeah.
What would add to that?
Well, you know, I add Prosecco to everything. So there's your go-to right there.
There you
but
go.
But you could put anything with it.
And then you found that little tonic that's less calories.
Yeah, you know, the little Fever Tree light tonic. They now have them in these baby cans.
So you don't waste
and
it.
Yeah, so you don't waste it. And mm-hmm. They're like 20 calories. So you could technically make a gin and tonic around 100 calories.
Mm-hmm.
That just makes me really happy.
Yes. Well,
because
well,
you can
and everyone's
kinda stay
got
on
the,
top of it.
Well, and everyone's kind of got the COVID weight on them.
I mean,
including
it's
me.
The quarantine 15 is what they call it. It's like when you go off to college and you gain the 15, the freshman 15. Now it's the quarantine
that's
15.
Cute. I hadn't heard that.
Oh, yeah, awesome. Yay. And then the quarantini and all these things that are coming up are kind of funny.
Well,
it
thankfully,
just
there's
is.
Some humor in there.
Exactly. We
okay,
all need
that. Okay,
but
what should we talk about today?
Well, I was thinking, mm-hmm. because I'm working on, you know, various different things, but I was thinking the other day how the entry of your home is so important. It oftentimes gets forgotten,
mm-hmm.
and it oftentimes doesn't always function the way that it should,
mm-hmm.
and it oftentimes does not have the impact or the invitation to the house
mm-hmm.
that it should. And whether it be your front entry that your guests are seeing or the back entry
where
that you go
comes.
In every
and everybody
yeah,
else
and all
seems
your back
to.
Yeah, your back door neighbors, mm-hmm. You know, or where you're coming and going every day. I think the entry is way more important than we give it credit.
Mm-hmm.
So I wanted to talk about it. I want
I
some
like
of your
this.
Tricks.
Well, I don't know that I have any. And it's funny that you decided on entryways because I have two entryways that are in dire need of help. So I have one really skinny entry in the back driveway that
everybody goes to.
Everybody goes to, and it's a hot, plain mess. And I want it to be more dynamic and fun and decorated,
okay.
which—
okay.
So, but it is narrow, so I don't, like, I could wallpaper it in a hot second, and it would look
fabulous
and transformed, but it'll get completely,
take a beating.
It'll take a beating, because we're mm-hmm. always going down to the basement, and throwing stuff in the garage, and blah, blah, blah. So, I think I could wainscot it.
Mm-hmm.
I just can't make up my mind. You and I, you know what, I need you to come over.
Well, we'll just look at it together,
yeah.
you know, that's interesting. I've always loved her little back entry. So
well,
it's funny
it
that
it's
not everything you want it to be. And that's kind of another kind of topic in its own right is that, you know, what might appear to guests as being okay might not appear mm-hmm. to, you know, you as the homeowner as being okay.
Well, I think the problem is, which you can attest to with me, is that I have like big dreams for putting an antique door in the, and so then I let it all.
And then you're like, that's not happening. And then you go, you just go way beyond to the next thing. Yeah.
And then the front entry, I've had it pulled together. I had a settee out there, but then I moved that to the living room.
Yes, you did.
And so then we
noticed that
big space, and we've been playing ping pong in there.
That's how big it is, you guys.
Yeah.
I think you had talked about your ping pong tournament in the front entry hall.
Which has been delightful, especially in the winter. We play outside this summer, but so now it's looking very bare and empty. And I had made a priority list for fall and the end of summer to work on things. And I realized that needs to move up because I need to get a banquette made and I need art and I need to get the mantle done in the fireplace that's in the entry. And what I do is I just sort of jerry-rig it, doing big floral that you just focus on when you come in.
Go big.
Big. And then, but with the ping pong table out of there, I have these big intake vents or outtake. I don't even know what they're. They're hideous. And I need a banquette. They have to be there, but I need a banquette. So that's moved up the list because we're going to be inside and we're going to be doing Christmas and it can't look like that. It's sad.
Gotcha.
It's sad.
Gotcha. No, it's not sad. Your entry is so beautiful. And, you know, it's funny you talk about a banquette. You know, that's one of the things that people often do is they put seating in their entry. And I think that's always a good idea, especially if, you know, people might be taking their shoes off, or the seating can also just be a landing place for stuff. Not to pile, but to just place it there as someone comes in for their handbag or whatever.
And then their coats if it's not a super formal thing. Yeah.
Of course.
It's nice. And I love to entertain. I love to do dinner parties in that front hall. And so I think a banquette with some small tables pulled up to it would be just darling.
Quite nice.
Because we have that fireplace there too. And so I want to use it. I like to be super, you know, what's the word?
Casual,
just
relaxed.
Agile. I like just, things. Yeah. I like to be able to move things around and entertain differently.
Oh, yeah, you like the flexibility. You like the flexibility. You definitely do. Well, okay. So this is a question. A lot of people put rugs in their entry. Yeah. Are you going to put a rug in your entry?
I don't think so.
Okay,
but
you've got the limestone floors.
I have the limestone floors, and then we have it outlined in a gray. So the creamy limestone center, and then the gray border, which I think is a nice technique. Because you can add a rug without it compromising.
Yes, it's
the form.
Well done. So a lot of times people, you know, when you inherit a house or perhaps you've purchased a home that was already built, you know, as a spec home or whatever it may be, sometimes those insets are incorrectly done, meaning they're so that they interfere with the rug or they're so small they get covered up with the rug. And
or
so
they're right in between, like half of
it's tweener.
And
is
I have made
too.
That mistake with a client who was insistent on an inset and it was super pretty.
Oh, I bet.
But it needed to be done differently so that they have some wiggle room.
With the rug and what have you.
Yeah, I think I would have done it differently or not at all. I was looking at your good friend Kat Lawton in Lux Magazine. Congrats to her for
Woo-hoo!
That photo shoot in a beautiful waterfront home.
I know, gorgeous.
But I liked how she had done just the herringbone black stone, and then she outlined it with the wood that ran out through the rest of the house.
That's a great connector.
It was a great connector and also warmed up what could have been a more sterile space with that, just that wood border. I love to do that.
That's a great trick. And then you also have, you have a tile that accepts the wet shoes and, you know, or you have a stone that accepts the wet shoes and all that kind of stuff. And you're not trashing your hardwood, but you have to connect your other flooring to the rest of the house. And it allows for, if you still want to do a rug, you can choose to do so, but you've got this inset that's, you know, intentionally placed. And I think that that's where a lot of people go wrong is they have the inset maybe, you know, like we talked about, not strategically placed.
Well, and I've even done, like in a square entry, I've done it where the floor kind of diamonds into the center. But again, it's tricky to then have some kind of, I mean, either you cover it all up.
Right.
And maybe you take it up for summer, and that's a nice thing to have bare woods in summer and spring. And you put a square rug in there. Mm-hmm. But if you just want the mat kind of at the door, the little rug at the door,
It's a little bit of a conflict.
It's a conflict. So,
you know, I just saw this entry in some publication, and I think it was a publication for, you know, times gone by. But anyways, where they painted the floor, and I love, 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 mm-hmm. like in an old farmhouse or something that has a little bit more crust and patina to it and can accept that. You know, taking the hardwood floors, designating that entry, and painting it.
Well,
you know?
And Bonnie Mellon did that the best.
Always.
The best in her country house was fantastic for the floors that she painted.
I think that's such a good trick.
And we follow, Lulu and I follow, I'm sure a lot of people do, William McClure. He paints all his floors white.
Oh, yeah.
White, white, white.
I'm all about it.
It's great. It actually, well, you
all about it. I have
here.
Painted white floors up
I love
here.
It.
Yeah. Mine's actually not really nice hardwood, but rather plywood for a more industrial look.
Yeah, it looks
but it
perfect.
Works.
It totally
yeah, it works.
Does. And your paint's holding up beautifully.
Oh, yeah. It totally works. I mean, we've had a really good success with it. It really lightens up this space.
But in terms of rugs, I will say I've gone into some entries of some homes where they have the sort of natural fiber rug, mm-hmm. and then they do an overlay of an antique rug.
Yes.
And my goodness, it is really welcoming.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I have a different kind of style, I think, mm-hmm. going on. I don't think that would look quite right.
No.
I could probably do the natural, mm-hmm. but not the, I don't know. But there's one entry in particular that's just really memorable. I just remember walking in and you just felt like this house is going
so
to just
great.
Wrap me up. And,
exactly.
Mm-hmm,
yeah.
Really nice.
I think it is too. The other things that I like to incorporate in entries, you know, are always like places for things to land. We talked about your banquette, but like a table's always nice. You can put a big bowl that catches the keys. We've often talked about how we like, you know, mirrors in the entry
Absolutely.
So you can check yourself, lamps.
I had a client once that argued extensively with me on the mirror in the entry, and I'm
Why?
Thinking, they didn't want to look at themselves or something, and I thought, okay.
I usually like if I'm going to go to the door or I'm going to leave.
Yeah, like do you have chocolate on your face
exactly.
or something?
Exactly. That is just like a giveaway. You've been naughty in the kitchen.
Right, exactly.
No, I mean, but I do like to take a quick glance before I go, you know, out the door or before I answer the door.
Yep. And I love having fresh floral. Like in my big entry, I bring
so
trees.
Inviting.
That's where I really bring my big trees in and out, my bay leaf
oh
trees
my gosh.
In the winter.
Speaking of trees, I have the funniest story.
Oh,
this reminds me. Okay, so, you know, a lot of people don't, especially in the older bungalows and what have you, they don't have a lot of space.
Sure.
So they don't have, like, a back mud room
that's
generous.
They can't play ping pong
They can't
in
play
there.
Ping pong in their, you know, front entry hall
yeah,
like you can.
That.
And so you have to, and there weren't a lot of closets, and you're having to get really creative with where we put the piles and piles and piles of mm-hmm. everything from hats and scarves to coats to whatever. So I don't know where I was or exactly when this was. It was so many years ago, but I was talking to a client and I was saying, well, you know, we could put a hall tree in this space right here in the entry.
Sure.
And da 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 da. And I'm talking 90 miles an hour. I'm sure I was.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm pretty, you know, this is what, 20 something years ago. So, you know, I'm still kind of fresh and all of that. And she looks at me. She just kind of like doesn't respond to anything. And she looks at me and she goes, I wasn't thinking of a plant in the entry. and she goes, what kind of tree? And I just
the whole tree.
It's
you know
a whole tree. And I started doing exactly what you just did. I went, it's a whole tree, you know. It's blah, 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 blah. And I started talking 90 miles an hour. Oh, I came back for the
tree. Because you didn't want her to feel stupid.
I didn't want her to feel bad, but she had never heard of a whole tree before. And she thought
That's
I was going to put
so
a big old
cute.
Plant in her front entry. And her front entry could not have taken it. That is for certain. But
that was polite of you. I probably would have said,
my
gosh, you don't know what a whole tree is, sister?
You
know, good for you.
Didn't know what to do. I just wanted to make her feel comfortable with the whole situation, and I didn't want her to feel like she didn't know what was going on. She didn't know what was going on, but, you know, there you have it.
That's so funny.
I love those back entries that also just have like the baskets. You have it at your back entry. It accepts mail or the outgoing things that need to go to the car or what have you. I mean, in my case, I throw all of our shoes just in one big pile in one big basket. But I think baskets are good containers.
No, they really are. And they add the texture that you need. And, you know, I have a
texture.
tiny little mudroom. Off the entry. And unfortunately, we put all the things we need to return. And it's,
it gets piled up.
People who just have these open mudrooms that you, I mean, some of them are closed doors, so you don't see them. But generally, you come in the back door. And when they don't have closed cabinetry, I just think it's such a mistake, like, because it's going to look like a hot mess all the time, except for the photo op.
So brilliant.
I love it seeing mudrooms and entries for the photo op where they have the perfect
basket and the perfect hat. And you're like, and you don't live that way.
You don't live that way all the time.
No,
you're going to put your red parka up there as soon as
you know you are. And yeah, all the other like backpacks and who knows whatever else. But I just think that whether it's the back entry or the front entry, it should be inviting. It should be functional. It should be beautiful. It should set the tone for the rest of the house, honestly, whether you're super tidy and tailored or whether you're a little more wabi-sabi or whatever
I
think
thoughtful.
It sets the tone.
And also, if you don't have dimmers when people come in, they may just run right back out to their car. I would. You know, they have them not too bright.
That's such a true point.
Yeah.
And the lighting is so important because harsh lighting is not welcoming at all.
No.
Ever.
We all want to look pretty by candlelight or at least some kind of warm glow.
Some softer. Yeah. You know, how do you feel about hooks and stuff? Do you?
Yeah, no, I have them. I like them.
I'm a big hook person.
And I think, I mean, I don't have a coat closet per se. So I have to use hooks.
Yeah.
And
I think they're lifesavers.
I do have a little bench in that little mudroom too. So people who do come in that way can put their stuff down or just throw it on the railing. You know, I mean, I'm not super fussy about that, but I don't have room to do like that specific coat closet.
A lot of people don't.
Well, we did originally have it planned in and then we had space constraints, zoning stuff. And
of course.
So they went away.
And you said, okay, and that's going to go away.
Yeah.
But I mean, even if you do it tidy at your front door, because that's the only place that you're entering and exiting every day as well as guests, you know, just keeping that kind of in mind. But you can come up with some cool looks.
You really can. And I don't get too fussy about stuff like that because that's just living. You've got to have some function in there. We all push again.
You have to have functions.
You have to have functions.
Yeah. You know, I was talking about you were talking about the lighting. I was talking about lighting with a client the other day and how I really wanted to add, you know, an entry, not necessarily chandelier, just a lantern, just something that felt like the space came down to a more human level. I think that sometimes if you walk into an entry and it's so grand and it's so big that that's also intimidating, just like the spotlight on you, you know,
it's so like the elevator shaft.
Exactly.
Entry.
Mm. So that was one thing that I was talking with her about. I guess they've just been kind of on my brain because I'm having to kind of deal with a couple of tricky ones, you know.
Especially. Well, we had, I don't know if you know this, but when that back hallway, initially you could see up to the second floor. There was railing ran straight across.
Oh, no, I didn't know that.
Yeah, and I argued extensively with the architect about that, and he was just really set on that. And I hated it from the get-go, so I finally just put a little floor over it so we have an extra landing upstairs, and I'm so much happier.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
Good.
I hated that.
I didn't know.
I don't like the entry elevator shaft.
Yeah, exactly. It's like you did that. Just,
the proportions
just,
were wrong.
It doesn't. It just doesn't feel right. That's another thing. It's like, you know, when you come in the entry, you want. Oops, I'm sorry. I hit my mic. You want it to feel like, you know, it's. I don't know. It's proportionate, and you feel proportionate. You feel proportionate in the space, and I don't know. A lot of people do things crazy with wallpaper and paint and all sorts of stuff.
It can be a fun little place to do something.
If you have,
and
a
I was surprised that you said
space.
You had used a linen paperback wallpaper. Right? In an entry.
I have.
Which is, they must be not hard livers.
Well, so this is an interesting architectural feature in that where I used it in the entry, it was a double door, which makes me crazy most of the time, the double doors, because one always sees more work than the other one, especially if it's a solid door and they're not like proportionate to the actual footprint of the house.
So you'd rather do
so
like two offset. Side lights?
Yeah.
Is what you prefer.
Or some, or, you know, when the door is shifted. So this was a double door, not in the center of the space like yours is in the center of the space.
Tricky.
This one was offset. So it was really awkward. And then the staircase was like, boom, right there. And then there was another wall behind it. So I put the wall covering on that wall that the stair was going down. And there was a stair going up, just like you were talking about, to try to soften and try to envelope the space. And because the door was offset, as I just mentioned, the double door, it was weird the way you walked in, but you never engaged with any walls. So I wasn't worried about anybody banging them.
I see.
You know, or running into
That's
them
nice.
Because it was this really awkward offset, but that was the one thing, because that was a consistent element in that space with a lot of other things going on that tied it all together.
Lovely.
I couldn't even figure out where do I put like a center lantern, chandelier, anything,
so
because
hard.
There were so many different things going on. It was like this, and usually when you think of an entry, it's long and skinny, but it's directing you into the house. This one was long and skinny on like the whole front of the house.
Oh, weird.
But it wasn't a porch, you know. It wasn't like a terrace or anything of the sort. So
tricky.
Yeah.
I was there's a beautiful house in Seattle that I know a lot of people. She's very generous with opening her home up for events and things. And she has de Gournay in her big hall and entry.
Yum.
And it runs all the way and it goes upstairs too. And she has young kids. And I asked her, you know, how are you maintaining
this?
And she said, oh, I just have the decorative painter come in occasionally and touch it up.
Just touch it up.
Yeah.
You can do that with de Gournay.
You can do that with
brilliant.
De Gournay, which is, it is kind of brilliant.
Because they're painting on that silk. Backed
exactly.
or linen backed.
Yeah.
I think it's linen and
well,
silk only, right?
No, they do a paper too.
And okay.
A beautiful
yeah,
paper.
That's right. They do a paper. I've been
that. And I like that the best, actually. But yeah, you can paint right over it. And I thought, good for her.
She's so smart.
Good for her to
so smart.
Just be like, it's okay.
You know what?
That bird got messed up, but we can make him perfect.
That bird got messed up. We're going to put his little beak back on or his toe or whatever got scraped off. Well, I don't know. I thought if you had any tricks up your sleeve that I would take them from you.
Sorry.
But I think the basic principles still apply in entryways, you know,
it's
make it functional.
It's just a fun place to set a mood. And
set a
I hope you do.
Yeah.
You really can kind of fake it in an entry until you get it just right. I've been doing it for years, but I'm going to have you over for a consultation.
Oh, that sounds like very exciting.
Yes, can you come Tuesday?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, good.
I'll
and
see
we
you then
should,
for sure.
We should have, you should start receiving next, let's see, this will come out. Well,
you should be receiving your bulletins.
Yeah.
The Schumacher bulletins have gone out and you should be receiving them.
So
and
lucky 30 plus.
Yep, it was in stages because we're trying to get more. And so anyways, you should be getting those. And hey, we also want to remind you, as we also try to remind ourselves to remind you, because we can't seem to remember, to follow us on Instagram.
Yeah,
engage with us on our website.
We
have show notes. We have a place where you can support us. There's a little bit more information there, but follow us on, you know, all the social media.
We're on Facebook
platforms.
Too, but
we
really
are.
Instagram's where we interface.
Instagram is really more
Sorry.
Of the interface because you're interfacing on it. But no, you can also email us, but it's designsalvation.com. And if you want to email at us, it's Dixie@designsalvation.com and Annie@designsalvation.com. It's really, really simple, but we appreciate all of you guys
we're
for
so
listening.
Grateful. Thank you.
We're very happy. And very grateful.
Yes, we are.
Ciao for now.
Ciao for now.
Hey, y'all. Don't forget to follow us on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. You can also find us at designsalvation.com, where we'll have the past podcasts listed as well as show notes. Hope to see you there.